started cooking a lot at home and going out a lot less. So how do you make the restaurant style food at home? So today I'm going to be showing you how to make the dal makhani right in your kitchens. I associate this dal with a lot of my childhood memories. Any festive season or occasion, my mother would make this dal makhani at home. And I particularly like to remember her and my family when I'm either cooking or eating this dal. So let's start cooking. For the dal makhani, I have soaked 3/4 cup of black urad dal, 2 tablespoons of red kidney beans or rajma for about 4 to 6 hours. Once they are nicely soaked, I will put them in a pressure cooker now to cook them. I have put the soaked dal and the kidney beans in a pressure cooker with 3.5 cups of water and a little salt, and I will put this now to pressure cook. I will start the next part of the process to make the dal makhani. For the tadka of the dal makhani, I have 1/2 chopped onion. I have 7 flakes of chopped garlic. A small piece of ginger, which I will blend together in a blender into a paste. 2.5 chopped tomatoes to be blended into a puree. 2.5 tablespoons of oil. Throw in the onion garlic ginger paste. The onions are translucent in color now. Throw in the tomato puree. The tomatoes are cooking in the pan along with the onion paste. They have kind of reduced now. I will now throw in all the spices. 1.5 teaspoon of chili powder. 1.5 teaspoon of turmeric powder. 1 teaspoon of coriander powder. 1.5 teaspoon of the Punjabi garam masala. Please check Everything Vegetarian's video on how to make the Punjabi garam masala. Cover it till the ghee or the oil leaves the sides of the pan. The tadka is now ready and I will wait to put it in once the black gram and the kidney beans are pressure cooked. How nicely pressure cooked it is. I will now throw in the tadka that I have made. Put another 1 cup of water, some salt to taste, and now I will let it simmer for about 5 to 7 minutes without the whisk. See the consistency, it has become nice and thick. You can add more water if you wish to make it a little more soupy with the rice, or you can let it be as is. The choice is yours. And now I will be putting the tempering on top of it. For the tempering, I will use 1 tablespoon of ghee, 1/2 a teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1/4 teaspoon of red chili powder, a pinch of asafoetida, 1 teaspoon of kasuri methi or dried fenugreek leaves, just pour it over the... So that's that, guys. the dal makhani, enjoy it with zira rice or with pudina naan and a raita. Have fun. Bye-bye.